Children, in this lesson, we will learn about multiplication. One day, Golu Panda found an injured bird outside his house. Golu bandaged her wounds and took very good care of her. The bird recovered and gave some apple seeds to Golu before leaving. Golu planted 2 seeds each in 5 pots. Can you tell how many seeds did Golu plant? In all, Golu planted seeds in 5 pots. And how many seeds did he plant in each pot? 2 seeds. Let's find out the total number of seeds by adding these seeds. Add 2 to 2. Again add 2. Again add 2. And finally, 1 more. How many seeds we get? 10 seeds. Each pot has 2 seeds. And there are 5 such pots. We can write it as 5 times 2. Or we can also write it as 5 multiplied with 2. The next day, Golu saw that big trees had grown from those seeds. When Golu saw the trees after a few days, he was unable to believe his eyes. Golden apples were growing on those trees. Golu was very happy to see this. Babban wanted to know the secret behind Golu becoming so rich suddenly. Golu narrated the entire story. The next day, Babban injured the bird by laying a trap. Then he took care of the bird just like Golu, and the bird recovered. Before leaving, the bird gave some seeds to Babban too. Babban planted 5 seeds each in 3 pots. Can you tell how many seeds did Babban plant in total? 5 plus 5 and plus 5. What numbers do we get? Yes, Babban planted 15 seeds in total. Now, how can we write it in a different form? 3 times 5 or 3 multiplied with 5. Children, if Babban had planted 3 seeds each in 5 pots, then can you write this by using multiplication? Yes, we can write it as 3 plus 3. Plus 3, plus 3, and finally, 1 more 3 equals to 15, or 5 multiplied by 3, or 5 multiplied with 3. We can write it like this. After planting the seeds, Babban was dreaming of golden apples at night. Suddenly, he heard a blast. When Babban went out to check, all his pots had broken. Once again, Babban became victim of greed. Children, in this lesson, we learnt how to multiply by adding repeatedly. In the next 2 lessons, we will see some more of its interesting examples. Children, in the last lesson, we learned how to multiply by repeated addition. In this lesson, we will see some of its interesting examples. Golu Panda's banana orchards reaped a good harvest this season. He thought that he can earn a lot of money by selling these bananas in the market. At the same time, Chanda Squirrel too had set up her flower stall. Golu had arranged 6 groups of 12 bananas each in this way. Children, can you write the number of bananas Golu had in the form of multiplication? 12 added to 12, again add 12, again add 12, again add 12, and finally add one more 12. How much is that? 72. Can you write this in another way? 6 times 12, or 6 multiplied with 12. At the same time, Chanda was selling 5 bunches of 7 flowers each. Children, can you tell the total number of flowers Chanda was selling? 5 times 7, or 5 multiplied with 7. We can write it like this. Now, how will we do this by using the method of addition? 7 added to 7, again add 7, again add 7, and finally add one more 7. So what is the total number of flowers? 35 flowers. The day turned into evening, but Golu couldn't sell a single banana. On the other hand, Chanda was happily going home as she sold all her flowers. Appu Elephant noticed the sad Golu and bought 12 bananas from him. Next day, there was a long queue at Appu's sweet shop. Golu was shocked to see this crowd. Just then, Appu came to his cart and gave Golu a sweet box and thanked him. Golu was confused. Then Appu told him that he had made a sweet from the 12 bananas that he bought from Golu. And everyone liked the sweet a lot. And now there are so many people visiting his shop today. Appu used 2 bananas for each sweet box, and he made 5 such boxes. Can you complete this table and tell how many bananas did Appu use in total? This is absolutely correct answer. Appu used 5 multiplied by 2, that is 10 bananas. So Appu bought all the bananas from Golu that day. Golu went home very, very happy. Children, in this lesson, we saw an interesting example of multiplication with repeated addition. Children, in this lesson, we will look at some interesting concepts related to multiplication by repeated addition. Do you remember the Raju's and Bablu's magical glasses? Today, once again, they wore their glasses and moved out to have some fun. Come, let's see what they see through their glasses. First, Raju and Bablu have arrived at Gaggu Rhino's toy shop. There is a box of balls there. In the box, the balls are placed in 4 vertical and 5 horizontal compartments. Raju wore his glasses and looked at the box. He saw a multiplication like this. Now Bablu wore his glasses and looked at the box. He saw a multiplication like this. Is this possible? Is the multiplication seen through Bablu's and Raju's glasses the same? Come, let's look at Raju's multiplication. Here Raju saw 5 horizontal compartments and 4 balls in each compartment. 4 multiplied by 5. Can you write this in another way? 4 times 5. Now, how will we write it in addition form? By adding 5 4 times like this. So, what is the total number of balls? 20. Come, now let's look at Bablu's multiplication. Here Bablu saw 4 big compartments and 5 balls in each compartment. 5 multiplied by 4. Now how can we write this? 5 times 4. And how to write in addition form? Adding 4 5 times like this. So how many balls do you get? This is also 20. The multiplication seen through both Raju and Bablu's glasses were exactly the same. Children, isn't it interesting? We can write any multiplication in 2 ways like this. And its answer will always be the same. Bablu and Raju were very excited seeing the multiplication magic of their glasses. They didn't realize that they had reached the park. In the park, 5 birds were sitting on a branch of a tree. This time, Bablu looked at the tree through his glasses first. He saw this multiplication. Suddenly the birds flew, and now there was one bird on 5 separate branches. Raju wore his glasses and looked at the tree. He saw this multiplication. Did Raju see the same number of birds as Bablu? Let's look at Bablu's multiplication first. 5 multiplied by 1. How can we write this using addition? Yes, we can add 1 5 times. So how many birds in total? 5. Now let's look at Raju's multiplication. 1 multiplied by 5. Can we write it using addition? No. Why so? Because 1 multiplied by 5 is 1 times 5, which gives you 5. Raju saw as many birds as Bablu. Both of them saw 5 birds. Now, as they walked around, Raju and Bablu reached Golu Panda's dairy. There they saw bottles placed in a tray like this. The tray had 5 vertical slots and 5 horizontal slots. This time, both Raju and Bablu wore their glasses together and looked at the tray. But what is this? They saw the same multiplication through their glasses. Both were shocked. How is it possible? What will happen if we write the multiplication of vertical slots? 5 vertical slots and 5 bottles in each slot. That means 5 times 5 or 5 multiplied by 5. And if we write the multiplication of horizontal slots, 5 horizontal slots and 5 bottles in each slot. Once again the same. 5 times 5 or 5 multiplied by 5. Therefore, both Raju and Bablu's glasses are absolutely fine and the multiplication shown by them were also same. Can you now find the solution to this multiplication? Absolutely right. There were a total of 25 bottles. Raju and Bablu went around the village happily dancing away. Children, in this lesson, we looked at some interesting concepts related to multiplication by repeated addition.